Street Show 2663.
Practice, Meryl. We're the audience, right?
Well, you want to be a good audience, don't you?
Yeah.
Well, then you have to practice clapping.
Okay, we'll practice clapping. Ready? Let's give Meryl a big hand, okay? How's this? Good?
Yeah, that's not bad, Gina. Not bad at all. But you must clap louder.
Louder?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, let's practice
louder. Of course, remember, Gina.
Yeah?
You're a Meryl Sheep audience now.
Okay, all right, so we'll do it louder. Ready? Good? Okay?
Yeah! Oh, you're getting better! Yeah! Just a little more practice.
Wait, Meryl.
My audience, they always clap very loud, Gina. Yeah, and then they yell, Bravo! Bravo! Can you clap and yell, bravo, bravo?
Well, I think we can. We can try that, right?
Good.
We can try to yell. All right, ready? Bravo! 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 Bravo!
Oh! Oh, you're getting there. Yeah.
Oh,
you just need to practice one more thing.
What's that, Meryl?
Jumping up and down.
Jumping up and down? Come on, Meryl.
Gina, my audiences, they always jump up and down. Yeah, when they see me in a play. Oh, they clap and they yell, bravo, bravo. And then they jump up and down. Yeah.
Okay.
Sometimes they even do handsprings.
Now, wait, Meryl. Okay, we'll clap,
right? We'll clap.
And we'll yell, bravo. And we'll jump up and down, but no handsprings. No.
Okay.
Can't do it.
You're a tough audience, Gina.
I'm sorry.
Very well. No handsprings.
Okay. All right, you ready? We're gonna clap, and we're gonna yell bravo, and we're gonna jump up and down, right? Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3.
Bravo! 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 Bravo!
I thought you were practicing for a play.
I am, Gina. I'm practicing the end of the play. The part where I take a bow and I say, thank you, thank you, thank you. Yeah. Let's keep practicing, shall we?
Okay. We'll keep practicing. Ready?
Yeah. Bravo! Thank you, thank you.
Room.
Oh, waiter.
Yes, sir.
Hello there. I am Grover. I am your waiter, and I'm here to serve you. What can I get?
Yes, I'd like a bowl of hot alphabet soup.
A bowl of hot?
Make sure it's hot.
Make sure it's hot.
Right.
Okay, sir. Coming right up. Hey, Charlie, table 26 wants a hot alphabet soup.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P.
How hot this is. You are going to love this. Oh, look at that delicious soup. There you are, sir.
Okay, I'll just check it out.
Check what out?
The alphabet.
Oh. Bon appetit.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. Waiter!
Yes, sir.
There's a J missing in this soup. I don't want it without a J.
A J missing in the soup?
Yes.
Oh. Okay, I get you the J. Charlie, I think there's a J missing in the soup.
Yeah.
A, B,
okay,
C,
there.
E, F, G.
I get that J for the man. Okay, here's the J, sir. Sir, here's your J.
Well, put it in the soup.
In the soup. Gotcha. Okay. There it goes. Okay?
Okay,
have fun.
Now, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N. Waiter!
Yes, sir.
Now the O is missing. No. I don't want this soup without an O.
That's a bad day for you, isn't it, sir? Okay, I get you the O. I'll be right back. Oh, the O versus the J and then the O. Charlie, I got a weird O.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O.
Sir? Yeah. Sir, I have an O here for you.
Well, drop it in.
Yes, sir, drop it in. There's the O, okay?
Check it out.
Check it out. Sure,
why not? A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y.
Don't tell me. Don't tell me.
No good.
I bet something is missing.
The Y is missing.
The Y is missing.
Nope, I'm wrong. I have a Y there.
I see the Y there.
Yeah, it's the Z.
See?
Yeah.
You can't always be right.
Well, okay, anyway, the Z, I get the Z. Missing.
All right, don't rub it in.
Without a Z.
It's a good restaurant, don't rub it in. I get the Z.
All right.
First, the Y makes a mistake, and then he wants to see.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
Okay, sir. I think I'm going to make you very happy now. I have the Z right here, sir.
Well, it's about time.
There he goes. Kerplunk.
Okay, now let's see. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X,
Y,
and Z.
And Z, there. Now I bet you are all happy.
Nope.
What?
The soup's cold. Take it back and get me another bowl.
Hey, Alan, what you doing?
Sometimes I want to get away. Off someplace where I can play. All by myself. Well, why not? Sometimes I just need the time to think about stuff while I'm all by myself. I do it a lot. Well, why not?
S. Serpiente. S.
Okay, now, Bigfoot, could you sing it for me just one more time?
Sure, Meryl.
Tweet, 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 tweet.
Oh, yeah, okay, I have it now. Tweet, 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 bah.
Not quite.
I thought I heard singing.
Oh, yeah, you see, I'm going to be in a play called The Sweet Bird of Youth. I play the bird, and I have to sing a bird song.
And I'm showing Meryl how.
Yeah. Would you like to hear my bird song, Mr. Hanford?
Sure.
Okay. Tweet, 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 tweet. Bah! Oh, that's not right, is it? Oh, what's that word, Big Bird?
Tweet.
Oh, yeah, tweet. A lovely lyric. I just wish I could remember it.
Why don't you just write it down?
Oh, hey, what a good idea, Mr. Hanford. Hey, there's some paper and a marker right there. Would you mind writing it out there for us?
Okay.
Yeah.
This ought to help.
Oh, I hope so.
T-W-E-E-T.
How's that?
Oh, there it is. Tweet. Gee, and you're not even a bird.
Okay, now where was I?
Tweet, 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 tweet.
Oh, okay, yeah, yeah. Tweet, 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 tweet.
Hey, that was perfect. Why, you sounded just like a bird.
Oh, well, I'm wonderful with accents. Everyone says so.
It looks like you're ready to play the bird on Broadway, Meryl.
Oh, not quite, Mr. Hanford. There's still one more thing I need to know about being a bird.
Oh, well, I bet I can tell you, Meryl. I know just about everything there is about being a bird. Why, I've been a bird for as long as I can remember.
Wonderful, Big Bird. Then tell me, how do I lay an egg?
You know what it's like to be scared? Not me. I'm not scared of anything.
It's just me. Don't be scared.
Far out.
Two. Oh, Ernie, hey, listen, I'm going to the supermarket to do our shopping.
Oh, have fun, Bert.
Yeah, but listen, Ernie, will you do me a favor? Will you please write down a list of the things we need while I go get my hat and coat?
A list?
Yeah.
You got it, Bert.
Great,
I'll
thank
do
you.
It.
Thank you.
All right. A list. Let's see, what'll I need to write a list? I'll need a piece of paper, and then I will need a pencil. All right with that. Pencil. If there's not a pencil here, I could write with a pen. Pen? Can't write with a... If there's no pen here, I could use a crayon, if I had a crayon. Hello, have you seen a crayon? A crayon down here. How about a marker? Marker pen would do it. Marker pen. Or I could use a typewriter, if I had a typewriter. No typewriter down here either. Aha! A paintbrush! A paintbrush! I could write the list with a paintbrush! Now I need something to dip the paintbrush into, some ink or paint or, I know what I could use. I have the perfect thing. Ooh. Mm-hmm.
Ernie? Hey, Ernie? Here, up. What is this mess? Hey, Ernie? Do you have that shopping list for me?
In a minute, Bert.
Okay, well, hurry up, because I'm getting overheated. Look at this stuff.
Okay.
What?
Okay, here it is, Bert.
Okay, so this is all the stuff you
this
want me to
is
get
the list. That's
at
right.
the store for us, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Pencils,
mm-hmm.
pens,
right.
crayons,
mm-hmm.
markers,
mm-hmm.
typewriter.
Yep.
Chocolate pudding?
Yeah, you see, I used all the chocolate pudding to write the list, Bert. Mm-hmm. Mmm, this is the most delicious shopping list I ever wrote, Bert.
Well, he's improving. Last time he used spaghetti sauce.
The letter S. Six snakes spent Saturday on the sand. For supper, they served soup, salad, spaghetti with sauce, sandwiches, and sausages, followed by sweets. After the sumptuous supper, the six snakes slept, snoring. The letter S.
Jaguar. Jaguar. Jaguar.
The baby's learning how to crawl. He's starting out little. Same one. And she's getting bigger. Walking. She crawled down. It's fall time. We got a new dress on. It's autumn. Dad, she can walk better. I'm pretty cold. It's almost winter. She's wood acting now. She stepped up. She thinks she likes those steps.
One, two, two.
Whoa! Hey, Oski! Guess what came in the mail?
What?
Look!
Oh, hey, look at that.
Yeah.
It's a postcard with a picture of swamp, mushy, muddy. Heaven.
Oh, and it's so wet.
Yeah, and muddy.
Oh, I wish I were there.
Yeah, me too. Hey, let's imagine that we are.
Yeah, imagine me and you in a swamp.
Swamp mushy muddy. Oh, I can smell it already. Yeah, and in this scenery, even you look good.
Oh,
and look at this, some skunk cabbage for you, to show you how I feel, you know. You can peep Niagara Falls, that's no place to be. You can bet the Taj Mahal's not for you and me. The Sahara's much too green, Coney Island's far too clean for a grouch to play. I want a place that's damp and slimy so I can sail with you right by me off on a grouchy holiday.
Go boat we do, go boat we do, go boat we do, go boat we do.
Birds trilling, bugs biting, it's thrilling, exciting. Love is a leaky canoe, alone in a swamp with you.
Boo-boo-be-doo, boo-boo-be-doo.
Toads creeping, snakes crawling, fish leaping, trees falling. I think that I'm falling too, alone in a swamp with you.
Boo-boo-be-doo, boo-boo-be-doo.
You never looked more terrible. You never looked more fair. Not good, just fair. You go so well with crocodiles. Stinkweed becomes you. It goes with your hair. Drops dripping, buds swelling, frogs flipping, skunk smelling. I want to spend my life through.
Ooh.
Up to my elbows in goo. Alone in a swamp. Alone in a swamp with you.
Don't you just love getting close to nature?
Yeah, and it doesn't get much closer than this.
Oh, Oski, that was heaven!
Yeah, imagining the next best thing to being there.
Now it's time for America's second favorite game show, the How Many Game, with America's busiest game show host, Mr. Guy Smiley.
Thank you. This is Guy Smiley, America's busiest game show host, and you're here to play the How Many Game, the game where people like you can win fantastic prizes by knowing your numbers. Now, our first contestant is Mr. Two-Headed Monster from Sesame Street.
Oh, God!
Hi there, Mr. Two-Headed Monster. Yes, and are you ready to play our game? Well, do you know how to play the game?
No.
Yes.
Okay, well, this is how it goes. Now, a very large number will appear on this board right over here. And all you have to do to win is to find that many of something, you see? For instance, if the number 7 came up and you came back with 7 apples, then you would win the game.
Oh, play!
Yes, all right. Well, let us see how much time you have to win this game. You have just 30 seconds to play the How Many game. And now let us see what your how many number is. It's the number 2. That's right. It's 2, and you have just 30 seconds to find 2 of anything. Are you ready, two-headed monster? Well, on your mark, get set, go! Yes! Go! Find something! Yes! Will he be able to do it, folks? The clock is ticking away, and he's got something here. Oh, I'm afraid that's 1 bowling ball. That will not do at all. Oh. You have to find 2 of something, two-headed monster. What's this? 1, 2, 3, 4 sheep. Oh, no, that's 4, Mr. Two-Headed Monster. That will not do either. You have to find 2 of something. And the clock is ticking away. What do we have here? 1, 2, 3 cows. No, Mr. Two-Headed Monster. That will not do either. Listen, Mr. Two-Headed Monster, you have to find 2 of something. And you only have 2 seconds to do it, and Mr. Two-Headed Monster.
Two heads!
Did you say 2 heads? Oh, then you win! Bold Pete, can you please get your sheep out of here, please? We'll go over those prizes later. Fantastic prizes. The train doesn't belong in here.
We win, Joe!
Tis my mom and me, and my brother makes 3, and as far as I see, we're a family, yup, a family. I love her, and she says she really loves me. That's the way it should be. So if you're or sometimes just with your dad. Or you could live with your grandma and grandpa. Or sometimes with your aunt and uncle. I even know a girl who lives with her aunt alone. But they're all family, just like mine. And that's the truth. Each home may be different, but I don't ask why. 'Cause love is all I need to get by. So if you're like me, love somebody and see how it works perfectly. 1, 2, 3, you're a family. Yup.
Mama? How do frogs make more frogs?
Well, let's look and find out.
May I help you, madame?
Yes, please. I'm looking for something in a coat.
Very good, madame. What sort of coat?
Well, let me think. I want something furry and blue.
I think I have the very coat, madame. I will show it to you.
Oh, good. What a nice store this is. I must tell Myrtle about this.
Is it not exquisite, madame?
Oh, it certainly is. What a beautiful furry coat. But I wanted something blue.
Blue?
Yes.
Yes. Madame has very particular taste. But I have another coat to show you.
What a pleasant man. Such nice service here.
Yes. Perhaps this is more to Madame's taste.
Oh, that's a beautiful blue coat. Nice buttons, too. But I wanted something furry.
Well, I regret it, Madame, but I have looked and I can't find a coat which is both blue and furry.
Oh, dear.
Dum 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 dum.
Look at that.
What? Where? What?
Isn't that a beautiful coat? Why, it's just what I wanted. It's furry and blue.
Thank you.
Let me try it on.
What?
And it fits perfectly. I'll charge it and wear it home.
Lady.
But, madame.
Dink. Hey, there's another sign. Oh, boy, I love these signs. Axe tie? I think that word's mixed up or something. I'll just change these letters around. There we go. At-ix. At-ix? It's not a word. Just put that letter there. Okay. T-A-X-E. T-A-X-E. Hey. Taxi!
Hey, hop in, bud. Hop in.
Hi, Louise.
Hi, Big Bird.
What you doing?
I'm making a sign.
Oh, I'm good at reading signs. Hmm? Love them. Let's see. Ring bell.
Yeah.
Oh. Well, what bell?
This bell.
Oh. Gee. What's it for?
Well, I got a lot of work to do in the back, and I want to be able to hear when someone comes into the store.
Oh, I get it. Mm-hmm. Hey, they just have to ring this bell, and then you'll know they're here, huh?
That's right, yeah. Well, listen, I better get to work. I'll see you later.
Okay. Okay, Louise. Gee. You know, I hope Louise can hear this bell all the way out the back there. Maybe I better try it out, huh?
May I help you? Oh.
It's okay, Louise. Don't worry. The bell works fine. You can hear it way out in the back, right?
Yes, I can hear it fine.
Oh, yeah. Good. Well, you better get back to work, Louise.
Yeah, okay. You're right.
Hi, Elmo.
Hi, Big Boy.
Well, Elmo, if you want Louise, you have to ring this bell here, see?
That bell?
Yeah, that's what the sign says, see? Ring bell.
Ring bell. Oh.
Big Bird.
Oh, it's okay, Louise. I was just telling Elmo about the bell here.
Hi, Louise.
Hi, Elmo.
Hi.
Well, listen, guys. I can't get any work done if you keep ringing the bell.
Oh.
Oh.
All right? No more bell ringing.
I promise. I won't.
Okay.
All right.
Oh, no! Elmo forgot to tell Louise something.
Oh, really?
Oh, Elmo better ring bell. Yeah.
Big Bird!
But...
Elmo!
Oh, no, Big Bird didn't ring the bell, Louise. Elmo did.
Yes,
yeah,
I know you did.
All by himself. Mm. Elmo has something to tell Louise.
What?
Elmo likes this bell.
Yes, I know you like the bell. Wait a minute.
Huh?
Guys, no more bell ringing, okay? I've got a lot of work to do.
Oh. Oh, it's okay. We probably better run along anyway. Come on, Elmo.
Oh, okay.
Bye,
okay.
Bye, Louise.
Bye,
Louise.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay, bye.
Bye-bye.
Hello? Hello? What's this? Ring bell.
I said quit ringing the...
But the sign says ring bell. Yeah. And if you don't want people to ring the bell, why'd you put the sign here?
Yeah, I...
I'm taking my business elsewhere.
And now Sesame Street is proud to present Mr. Billy D. Williams and a honker to count backwards for you.
Ready? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3,
two. Oh, why don't you do the last one?
May I help you, sir?
Yes, I'm looking for a hat.
Oh, yes, sir. Of course. Yes. Well, oh, how about this?
No.
How about this?
No, not at all.
Then. Just the one. Well, how about this? No, this? You like this? Here's a nice one. How about this number? Oh, I think you'll just love it. No?
No, these hats look just like one another. They're all the same. Same color, same shape, same size. Don't you have a hat that's different? A hat that doesn't look like all the others. A different kind of hat.
Well, aha! Here's a big, white, 10-gallon hat. It's not the same.
No, it's different, all right.
Of course, you'll look funny wearing that one without a horse.
Yeah, it's a good thing I brought one along. Ta-da!
Yeah!
We take you now to Kermit the Frog with another fast-breaking news story.
I see. So that used to be a pumpkin, and you used to be a mouse, huh? Well, I wonder if the audience would believe that. Hi-ho! This is Kermit the Frog of Sesame Street News. And I'm standing here next to the horse that used to be a mouse. And on this side right here, we have Cinderella.
That's me.
Mm-hmm. And over here, we've got Cinderella's fairy godmother.
Right here.
Mm-hmm. And this is a very exciting moment because in just 1 second, Cinderella's fairy godmother is going to make a beautiful gown so Cinderella can go to the ball and meet the prince. Hmm?
Yes, she'll hop in that coach over there.
Right.
And she'll go to the prince's place.
Oh, that sounds just wonderful. So, fairy godmother, do your stuff.
Right.
Okay, tighten in on her there, folks.
Mm-hmm. Eye of worm, more or less, makes Cinderella a beautiful dress.
Ew! This is no dress. This is a bathing suit. I can't wear this. Ew!
Oh, dear, I'm so sorry, Cinderella. I made a mistake. Didn't I?
Uh-huh.
Well, I'll have to try it again.
Uh-huh. You see that, folks? She is going to try again. Carry on.
Eye of worm, more or less, makes Cinderella a beautiful dress.
Pajamas? Ew! What is this? I can't wear this to the ball. Ew!
I'm sorry, Cinderella. I made a mistake. I'll try again.
You see that, folks? Cinderella's fairy godmother is going to try again. She is not going to give up.
Carry
no,
on, carry
no.
on.
All right, but I'll use my super duper magic words for this. Nose of bat, possum thighs, lion's foot, and 10 French fries. Tail of mouse, fur of teddy, make Cinderella a dress already.
Wait a second.
May I try one?
Cinderella, come back here.
Cinderella, let's go. You're
going to
be late.
I've got the dress on.
Come on.
But I'm not Cinderella. She's inside the house. But wait a second. I don't want to go to the ball.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
This is Kermit the Frog returning you to your regularly scheduled program. This is embarrassing.
You think we can do anything about it?
Humiliating. No. What kind of food do they serve there anyhow?
Ah, mi casa.
Hey, qué bonita casa.
Mi casa es su casa.
Oye, muchas gracias.
You, Dinger. Ah, yeah. Yes, it does say ring bell, but not your bell. No, it doesn't mean ring your bell. It means ring this bell. Yeah, right. Yeah. Wait a minute, no, Dinger, wait a minute. This is not a toy. It's for my customers. Oh, you brought that in to get it fixed. Oh, well, that does make you a customer. And it does say, I did say the bell was for the customers. That's right, yeah, I did. This is not what I had in mind.
Hey, look, it's the letter J. So, letter J goes J. Hey, here he comes. What's that? Oin, oin. Oin. Join. There they go. Join. Look at that big ump. It's blocking the track. Jump. I know. Jump. Jet. Now he's junk.
In what ways do you think we're the same, and in what ways are we different?
Our hands are different.
Mm-hmm.
Your hands are different. I'm pink skin, and your hand is skin.
Well, my skin is sort of orangish in color, isn't it?
Where's your arms?
Orange. You know, the color orange.
Where's your arms?
Where are my arms? They're inside my sleeves. And you have arms inside of your sleeves? Where are your arms?
Right here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I scratch myself a lot.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm. Mm.
And let's see. So we're alike in many ways. How do you laugh, Katie?
You know.
How do you laugh? We're so much the same, Katie. I think we're probably related to each other. Don't you?
Tough as rocks, meanest dudes on the whole block. So it may come as quite a shock that when we're feeling sad and blue,
we big kids cry the whoo. Yes, we do. Yes, we do. We big kids cry the whoo. Boo hoo, wah wah, zap zap. Boo hoo, wah wah, zap zap.
We can cry loud, we can cry low, and we want everyone to know that when you're feeling down or misunderstood, a little cry can do you good. Clear the air, cheer your mood. A little cry can do you good. Boo hoo, wah wah, zap zap. Boo hoo, wah wah, zap zap. A little cry can do you good.
Hey, hey guys, cheer up. Look, I got a great big box of popcorn here. Let's go to the park and eat it.
Oh, sure, right. Kid. That's great. Oh, golly. Well,
wow.
You're nice for a chef.
Popcorn.
And now, it's time to play Name That Food with Don Carrot.
All right, players, you know the rules. A food type is flashed on the game board. First player to identify it and eats it wins the round. Ready?
Celery!
Correct. Will you eat it?
I sure will.
That's 25 points for Debbie. Now, here's our second food.
Is it liver?
You're right. Will you eat it?
I'll pass.
Number one?
Yes!
That's 50 points and a big lead by contestant number one, Debbie. Now, here's your next food.
I'll guess squash.
Will you eat it?
No way.
I will, Don.
That gives you 75 points. Now, for the final round and the championship. Take your time.
Spaghetti and meatball.
Right. Will you eat it?
Well, I never have before.
Number one, will you eat it?
It's good.
That's it. Our champion with 100 points. Well, that's all the time we have. This is Don Carrot reminding you to try a new food today.
All contestants win a free coconut, fresh broccoli, 2 dozen fresh extra large eggs, and a pound of Gouda cheese.
Dinger, please stop ringing the bell. Dinger, if you don't stop ringing the bell, it's going to break. Now you see? It's broken. The bell is broken. Mm-hmm. It's okay. Don't worry, though. I know you didn't mean to break it. These things happen. You want me to fix it? No, I haven't got time to fix it. I'm going to have to find another one. Maybe I'll borrow one from Gina. What? Oh, you've got one I can borrow? Oh, okay. Now, isn't that nice of Dinger to try and make up for breaking the bell? Ring, Dinger? Oh, you want to be my bell? Oh, I... But that's very nice, Dinger, but I don't think anybody's going to ring you. Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters J and S and by the number 2. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
This is PBS.